Can you describe this vector right now? If your answer is no, you are correct, because you need a coordinate system. Now, with this coordinate system, the vector is at 1, 0. And then your boss brings up a different coordinate system, and he says it is 0.7, 0.7. Unfortunately, this is correct as well. But wait, why the heck am I talking about this? If you are an engineer and working in the areas of robotics or game engine, you really need to describe a vector of a flying apple to catch in multiple different coordinate systems. If your product fails so, the user of your product may end up with an in a very awkward situation. The user doesn't know you, but still, he may come for you. If you need a program or software that is used in a multiple air traffic control tower to display a moving object velocity, just use a rotation matrix of a specific coordinate system so that the operator can expect the airplane is coming from its east or west. If you need to program an autopilot algorithm to control a drone in real time, simply implement a rotation matrix on board so it can balance in the middle of the air. The rotation matrix, unlike its name, it doesn't even require crazy math. First, define your base coordinate system or ground frame. Then, identify what's the relative rotation of your target coordinate system. Perform high school level trigonometry tricks that you failed once, then copy-paste values in the right location. Then that is your matrix. Just in case if you still didn't get it, please pause the video and try to decipher this code like Neo, and you'll see a whole new world in matrix. And the rotation matrix is pretty easy to scale to 3D rotation. You can keep adding zeros and ones for the unused axis and multiply them. In Python, it's just a few lines of code. Once you're finishing implementation, you don't even need to think about it anymore, just like all cool engineers do. What are the good features of the rotation matrix? If you need to keep rotating a vector here and there, you can simply multiply them from right to left. Why not from left to right? That's how the matrix is built and the agents are watching for it. Or you can always go back to the source. Also, converting back to the other frame backward is so simple, just take a transpose of the matrix and then multiply the vector. Your vector description will be seamlessly converted back to the previous coordinate system. To wrap up, you are a robotics engineer for a drone autopilot software. Your drone detects an eagle coming in your ground frame coordinate. You know it needs to move to the direction of -0.1, 0.8. Now, what is the direction in terms of your drone's coordinate system? You can simply calculate this using the rotation matrix. Still didn't get it? Well then, embrace your destiny and enjoy like a pro. If you liked the video, please don't forget to like it and subscribe. This is Elliot, I'll see you in the next video.